Hey guys, what's up? So Valentine's Day is over, unless you're watching this video a year from now. But really, every day is a day when you can be heartfelt. So I'm going to show you how to make this flicker heart, and this is how it flies. Whoa. All right, so that's from a 3x7 rectangle. This is from a single dollar, and this is how it flies. For the dollar flicker, click here. For the 3x7 rectangle flicker, ready, set, here goes. All right, so for this heart, I used a sheet of printer paper cut in half, the long way. All right, so this is a red sheet of printer paper, so begin red side up. In other words, it doesn't matter which side to start on. But if you're using a sheet of paper that's colored on one side and white on the other, then begin white side up. Okay, let's start out by making a little pinch mark in the middle here. So let's fold this corner to this corner and make a little pinch right there and unfold, and let's repeat on this side and unfold. Now let's fold the bottom edge to our two pinch marks. And fold sharply. Now let's rotate and let's fold in half. Crease sharply and unfold. And now let's fold this flap so that this edge aligns with the middle crease. Make sure it perfectly aligns and fold sharply. And now let's repeat on this side. Let's fold this edge to this edge. And make sure that the two edges are pressed up against each other firmly. And once again, fold sharply. Okay, let's turn over and let's rotate and let's fold this edge to this edge and rotate and let's fold this edge to this edge. Okay, now let's fold this edge to this edge. And let's unfold and unfold this flap. And let's fold this flap so that this edge aligns with this edge. And now let's fold this flap over this edge. Just wrap it over. And let's unfold it and unfold. Okay, let's repeat on this side. So let's fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with this edge. And unfold this flap. And let's fold this flap so that this edge aligns with this edge. And let's wrap this edge over this edge. And unfold and unfold. Okay, let's rotate and let's unfold this flap and unfold this flap. Now let's fold this edge up right on the crease. But we actually want to lift this flap up and just fold it so that it goes along the whole crease all the way to the corner, and then you can let it go back down. So we just folded it inside like that, And let's repeat on this side. So make that fold continue underneath, and continue all the way to the corner and fold it back down. Now, if you're using A4 paper, this flap is going to be a lot longer, and that's fine. Just fold it all the way inside. Okay, let's refold here and here. Now let's fold this flap into this pocket on the existing crease. Like that, and let's repeat on the left side. Okay, now let's open this pocket, stick your finger in there, and let's squash it down so that this point connects with this point. Okay, and let's do the same thing on this side. Now let's fold this flap up. How far? Well, we want this edge and this edge and this edge to be the same length. So just estimate it. It's about like that. And crease it sharply. And let's repeat on this side. So make the two flaps equal. Crease them sharply. Okay, let's rotate. And now we're going to do a tricky fold, but before we do, I want you to turn over and you see the heart is done. So if you're okay with it like this, then you're all set. But if you want to make it so that the back is tightly locked so that it'll fly really well, then this is how to do it. So let's rotate and let's fold this flap, this interior flap, down. We want to fold it so that it goes into this pocket here. And we're folding it on this line right here. So it's kind of tricky, but you want to open up the pocket and fold that flap underneath. So it's like that. Now, before you actually flatten it, let's adjust that fold so that when you flatten it, it's not going to cover up this edge. So just kind of angle it downward a little bit. So it's like that. I'm going to show you from inside. Basically, this corner goes as far in as it can go. So it's like that. And now let's fold this edge to the crease. And let's fold this flap so that it goes right on this corner. And we want the edge to go to about right here. Like that. And you can fold this little corner so that it doesn't stick out, because we are going to stick it into this pocket. So let's grab it and just pull it so that it can go right into that pocket. Like that. And that's a tricky step, but you get the idea, hopefully. And flatten. And this side is all locked. Let's repeat on this side. So let's open up this pocket like this, and we're going to fold this flap inside right on this line. So it's like that, and let's make that fold just curl a little bit under so that when we flatten it, it doesn't cover this edge. So it's like that. And now let's fold this edge to this crease or to this edge. And let's fold this flap on this point. So it's about like that. And let's take this whole flap, and we're going to stick it into this pocket. So grab it and just stick it into the pocket and slide it all the way in. Like that. And make all of these folds really sharp. And there we have it. Turn over. And so here's the heart flicker. All right, let's try to fly this thing. All right, so how to fly this thing? Well, first you want it to have some curvature. And the curvature should not be like this, but rather like this. So the convex side is on the spiral side, like this, and both sides. And it's good to even use the edge of a table. But don't do that. I broke my heart. It's good to use a table, but be careful not to tear it. So that's like that, and this side is curved like that. So now it should fly pretty good. All right, so to fly this thing, you want the spiral part to be on top, and you want to hit it right on the round part of the heart, ideally right on this edge. And you want your finger to be perpendicular to the surface of the heart. So it's not like that, and it's not like that, but it's just straight on, perpendicular. And you just want to hit it hard and try to give it a little bit of extra oomph by bending your finger as you hit it. And it's really just about finding that sweet spot right there on the edge. Okay, here it goes. Let's see how it flies. I didn't hit the sweet spot. Let's try again. I hit the sweet spot, but I didn't have enough oomph. That was pretty good. It had plenty of lift, so that means I can point it down a little bit more. That was sweet. Yeah. So what I find is that this is just a little bit too flimsy to really fly far. So if you want it to really fly far, then you need to have more substance. So in order to give it more substance, I recommend using a full sheet of printer paper folded in half
rather than half a sheet of printer paper with the cutting. So it's really hard to fold that way though, but it goes farther. Here it is. Yeah. So there you have it. All right, I hope you guys enjoyed folding this, and I hope you love the model as much as I do, and hope you're able to apply it well, and I'll see you later. Bye bye. Oh well.